Hi everybody, this is our 10 channel traffic light controller. Plus, it has 4 buttons options. This is our input. This input can support AC voltage and outputs also AC voltage. This input can be 110 volt or 220 volt or between any values. Same thing for the output. Input can be also 60 Hz or 50 Hz. Board is automatically going to understand if it is 50 or 60 Hz. You don't have to do anything. This is our nano chip here. It is Arduino based. It means that you can program this board depends on your application. When you receive the board, the board is going to have preloaded sketch on it itself. Today, what we are going to do is we are going to try to make a simple demo. How can we modify existing sketch with our computer? As you see, this device is connected to my computer via type C plug. When you plug, it is going to turn on automatically. And when you have the power here, if even you don't have the plug-in, it is going to also start its sketch itself, built-in sketch. Okay, so let me give you a little bit more information about the board. Okay, so let me open my image here. This is the large form of my board. As you see, each output has some identification characters, L1, L2, L3, all the way L10. And we call also L1 red, L1 here. Each pin here corresponding another pin number, GPIO number for the Arduino Nano. For example, when it is L4, when you reverse back the board, let me go to that image. Let's look at the L4. L4 means red L4, it is GPI 06. Okay, so let me bring you back to my Arduino coding. This is that one. So red L4 corresponding to pin number, GPIO number 6 on my Arduino chip. Okay, so as you see, we have some another include files here. I'm not going to go to all the details. When you purchase this board, you are required to know our basic Arduino knowledge. Even we call this one 10 channel traffic light controller, you can control any device running by AC with this device. Depends on your application. Currently, it can run like a traffic light controller. Again, you can do whatever you want. Okay, plus we put some buttons options here. And also, I would like to mention one more thing. Let me go to my image again. We have also other communication here, like transmitter and receiver, SDA, SCL. So this board can easily communicate with the other boards. Okay, as long as you know how to configure those, you can still continue. Also, whenever you hit the button, any button here, you are going to see, because we already programmed like that, you are going to see a button press here. And again, same thing here for the output. You don't have to plug into the production area with your Type-C cable when you plug in. As you are seeing right now, you can see the indicator here. Whatever, for example, when this is turned on, it means that one of the terminals here, which one is this one? L5. L5 here, so it means this L5, I'm sorry. I need to bring this one to here. L5 and neutral is going to have high voltages. Okay. Also, the other thing I want to mention here, since I am working with the here DC volt, which is very low power here, 5 volt to ampere, I can touch device without any warning. But when I have the AC input here, you have to make sure that you are in safe, otherwise it is going to be dangerous. Okay, so let's go back to the coding again. I'm going to close this. Alright, so let me go back to the here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to close this and let's see how we are going to do from the start point. So I close it. Okay, now I have a folder here. Okay, you cannot see that one. Let me do from the beginning again. I'm so sorry. So here is my folder. Okay, when I double click, there is a file here, zip file. This is the file I downloaded from its website. Okay, so when you right click, you are going to extract all. Then it is going to ask you something here like this. Then I'm going to say extract. Okay, now all of them are here. So this is the unzip folder. Okay, now okay, because of the zipping zip program, it created many folders in it. It is okay. So when you double click this one, 10 channel button update, 10 channel button update. Yeah, when I double click this, it is trying to open Arduino software here. It is on my other screen right now. As soon as it is on, loaded, I'm going, okay, it is here. Cool. See, everything is here. Very cool. This is the main application. Okay, as you see, as I said before, L4 is already identified here with the pin number 6 for my Arduino chip. And we have another include file here. Maybe when you run this application with this button, you might have error. What you are going to do is you are going to go to the manage libraries. If you see the timer one error. Alright, my library manager is already loaded. What I did is I just type here timer 1, which is the include file here. Then I hit my enter. This is the one I already installed. If I didn't install, you are going to have install options here. Since I already installed, it is asking me only update, but I'm not going to update. That's fine. Okay, so let's go back to the R files. We have some include files here, which were already in my folder. When I open my Arduino file, they have been already loaded. Okay, so this is the one for button A. Okay, this file is button B, this file is button C, this file is button D. Let me show you how it works right now. If I hit this button, okay, as you see, my indicator turn on, it means that, okay, I see that you hit the button. Now, okay, as you see, when I hit the button D, all of them are flashing, okay, which are happening here. As you see, what is happening? Let's see. Red, L1, high. So then L4 is also high. Yellow, L2 is also high. High means that turn on, turn on, turn on. It means it is turning on all of them at the same time, as you see here. Then it makes half second delay. Then turn off. Low means here, turn off. Then half seconds delay again. Then it goes back to the here. On, off, on, off. Okay, this one is for the button C. Button C. All right, so let me put this one here. Button C is only turning and turning off either orange color or red colors. This is what it does here. Okay, let me go back to my main menu. Here, I mean main application, we are identifying the pin numbers here on my board to my chip. Then what we have here is we have click options. See, when button A click one function is going to run. When button D click four button is going to run. When you double click the button four, it means double click four button is going to run. So let me double click here. This is my just cable, okay? One, two. Oh, I couldn't do it. Hold on. I need to do numbers. Yeah, I need to do here. See, because since I was in the type C at that moment, the last thing I did was the type C, right? Then I have to go. Now it backs, right now it is in the main cycle right now, because when you double click to the type C, I mean button C, it puts its application to the main cycle. This is how we programmed. You can program again, depends on your application. Okay, so what is happening when we click to the button 4? When you click to the button 4, okay, what is happening is it is calling to include file 5, which is this one. As you see, 05 underscore all underscore flash dot h, which is same thing here. So when you click that one, this is the one it is going to run. Okay, so I'm going to make small changes here. Let me make this one more delay. Instead of half second, I wanted to make this one 1 second delay. Okay, 1000 means here, 1000 milliseconds, it means 1 second. Then what we are going to do, we are going to select Arduino Nano here. Okay, then what we are also going to do, we are going to select here Arduino as a processor. We are going to set alt bootloader. Okay, currently this is working with this one, but in the future it might work this one too. So make sure you try both options if it doesn't work. Okay, so I just click this one. Now I'm uploading all my files to the here. It says here, by the way, COM7. Let me see if I can show you that too. Oh, it is not going to work because I had to select the communication port 9. Okay, so this is going to fail. It is okay. This is also another opportunity to show if when we get the error, what we are going to see. So it says here, cannot open device / COM7. Yeah, because we made a mistake. Okay, now I have to select the COM9 here. Okay, now let's go back to run again. This is the button when I need to upload my code to my board here, I have to select this. Okay, it is running. All right, cool. As you see, uploading, okay, done. So let me show you how it works now. I'm going to click my button D. As you see, indicator turn on. When it is time to go, it will go there too. It is waiting first cycle to be done. See, it is slow now, very slow. Okay, so let's make this one more fast. Instead of half second, before it was half second, then we made it to 1 second. Now I'm going to make it more fast. So 100. Okay, I'm going to repush my code again with my button here. So let's see how it works with much faster way. Okay, what I'm trying to do here, I'm just trying to give you the idea how it works. Then you can make your Arduino programming to depends on your application where you are going to use. You can make different thing and different purposes with different purposes. As long as you are using the AC devices here. Hold on, let me push again. Okay, now, okay, as you see, it is so fast now. All right, cool. Again, if you have any questions, you are welcome to ask me. We love to help our customers. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.